Hi, and welcome to a quick introduction on how to use sound in boom cards. Sound is a lot like images. So let's just go ahead and get started. We're in the template card here. I'm going to grab a sound widget from the widget bar there, drag it in, and it brings up a sound picker. So just like the image picker that we're familiar with, this is the sound picker. And I can go into this folder, preview a sound. I click it. You might not be able to hear it. My microphone might not be picking that up, but I can preview the sound there. Let's say I like this one, funny. I select it, and there it is. It's attached to that guy. Now, some people get a little concerned because they're like, wait, I'm clicking it and it's not playing. But this is the editor, so we don't play the sound here. If you want to hear what it actually sounds like, go into the previewer, click it, play it, and you can test it that way and make sure you're happy with it. Now, we'll come back over here. We're looking at our sound, and some people look great, but I really didn't want like that speaker thing. I wanted to click something really interesting. And so I'm going to show a couple of different ways you can accomplish that. I'll do that by maybe just give an example. Like, let's say we wanted to speak a number when the user clicks it. So on this slide, that should be like the number 2 and so on. Might have the number 3 down there. I could just drag my little sound guy on here, and let's change this Z order and do a send it to back. There we go. So now if I run this, I will in fact click the number and hear the sound, but yeah, that's certainly not what anyone wanted. So let me show you what we really want to do to make this perfect. We'd want to size this guy so that it's big enough. So if I click up here around the 1, I still activate this. And then this sound object has a background image, which happens to look like a speaker. So let's go in here and I'm not sure actually if we can clear it outright like that. Let's see what happens. That seems to work. And now when I click, when it appears like I'm clicking the 1, but I'm actually clicking the sound icon with no picture, I can hear my sound. Now, when I go back over here, that sound, that invisible object is still there. I can see this is the image and this is the sound. Another way I could also do this, but this only works if my image files are all very consistently sized, is I can change the background image to my number that I want. The reason why I say they have to be consistently sized is because there's no way for our background images to scale to fit. We always scale to fill, so it will distort. And so that may not be a great solution, but it might be the perfect solution if you're using digits like I am and they're all, you know, just the perfect size, then those will work great. So let's review. You can put an image or a text box with a word you want to pronounce, for instance, like the number 1. And so then you could drag your sound. Let's pick, let's get this sound. And we could drag that sound over the top. And we want to make sure that this guy is in the front. And then we can go to the background image and either clear it outright, which I guess that works, or change the opacity to the speaker, which is on item opacacity. Now you'll see the speaker's fading out as I do this. So we just change it all the way to 0. So then no matter what image or artifacts that are on that thing will just be invisible. So the opacity is 0. That thing is completely invisible. And so when I preview that now, when I click on here, I hear my sound, and it looks like I'm clicking the word to do it. So So that's a couple of ways to accomplish the same thing. Let's just do a quick review. Grab a sound, drag it out, put it on the page wherever you want it. Use the sound picker to pick the sound that you want. Assign the sound, size and shape your sound object and stick it in front of whatever you want to make a sound when you click it. Or you can change the background to a different image if that's what you want. Or you can change the opacity under the here and just make it invisible so that when you put it over, and then again size it so it neatly covers up the thing that you want the user to click on. Okay, that's it. That's using sound in boom cards.